From serving our country on the battlefield to protecting our community, Matias Ferreira has overcome many obstacles that have led to his achievements today. He's a Marine veteran, police officer, and challenge athlete extraordinaire. Matias joins us now to share his story. Do I have that name right, young man?
You do, yes, sir. Matias Ferreira.
Okay, Matias, I'm sorry. Let's talk a little bit about the day that changed your life forever.
Yeah, so January 21st, 2011, I was deployed to Helmand Province, Afghanistan, with 1st Battalion, 8th Marine, 2nd Marine Division out of Camp Lejeune, North Carolina. And I was a machine gunner attached to a platoon, and we were just running our course in Helmand Province. And on January 21st at nighttime, we went into a compound where they said that IEDs and Taliban were operating. And so we went and took the team to the rooftop. And when I jumped off, I landed on a 30-pound bomb, and both legs were amputated below the knees, amongst other injuries.
That moment, I mean, you knew you were in a world of hurt, right? I mean, or does shock set in?
Yeah, the shock sets in, and I think it's more so the surrounding areas that kind of shock you. You hear people screaming, like, don't move, look for secondaries. And you see lights flickering in the night, and you're not sure exactly the extent of your injury at the time. And, you know, you realize that you're in some pain.
And we're looking at that picture of you in the hospital bed. That expression kind of says it all. A lot of people just pull the plug there and say, hey, they quit on life. You chose not to. Explain where you found that inner strength.
Well, I had my family. I think that religion to me, faith was a big thing. You know, I knew that God had a big purpose for me. He had a goal for me. And I just wasn't really quite sure what it was. And having the support of my family there, my mom, my dad, my brothers, my fellow veterans were there, just kind of cheering me on was a huge, huge help.
And then at some point, Bob Abbott and the Challenge Athlete Foundation enter your life. And that had to be life changing as well.
No, absolutely. Absolutely. The amount of work that he does and everybody that works with them is phenomenal. I've been working with the kid named Landis Sims, who's a quadruple amputee.
Yes.
And we've been doing a lot of stuff with them. And I think that he is really the image of what CAF really does for people is, you know, they set him up on a path of no excuses and just trying to find that perseverance to keep moving forward.
So you were an elite athlete to begin with, obviously, to do what you were doing. You found a way to stay an elite athlete. When did you find your passion? It's cycling, right?
Well, the hand cycling, I mean, I was doing everything. I was scuba diving, doing jiu-jitsu, running. I mean, anything that I could get my hands on and just set a goal and something to achieve, look for that purpose was really anything I was looking for.
And now you compete as... Are you competing? A lot of these series, we have a kid, people are like trying to compete for the U.S. Olympic team and whatnot. Is there a sport now that is your sport that you're trying to become an elite at?
I'll be honest with you. I haven't really found the exact sport that I love because running is something that I use as therapy and also to keep me in good shape because of the job that I do. I do jiu-jitsu, which really just started about 2 years ago for me. And that was really a means of learning how to manipulate my body and learning how to move again and just really finding the new normal for myself. But anything that you throw at me, I think I've been able to enjoy wheelchair basketball, volleyball, running, cycling, skydiving. I mean, anything.
Let's not bury the lead. You also work on the law. You're a policeman.
Yes, sir. I'm a policeman. I went into the police department maybe almost 5 years ago in September. And, you know, it's kind of strange for me because I didn't know if I was going to have an opportunity to do the job that I'm doing now. I spent countless days and hours on Google looking to see if there was any other double amputees, and I wasn't able to find any. So when I was starting the process for the police department here in New York, I asked them, I said, hey, is this going to be an issue? And they said, as long as you pass your physical and you get a waiver from the military saying that you're able to really stay fit and do the duties of a police officer, then we have no problem. And I think I've set a pedestal for other
Absolutely.
Veterans who want to join the Molestar.
What an amazing story. And as we wrap this up, I mean, I'd like you to expand on your motto, life without a limb is limitless. Could you share those words of encouragement?
So I play on a team. It's called the USA Patriots. And it used to be called the Wounded Warrior Amputee Softball Team. And we were starting to travel the country playing softball against all able-bodied teams. And there were kids coming to these games who were missing limbs. And we wanted to really just spread that motto that life without limbs is limitless, that now with the technology and the engineering world that we have, anything's possible. You want to run and you have running prosthetics. You want to scuba dive, they have scuba diving prosthetics. I mean, all sorts of different technology. So we just want to let people know that just because you have a disability, it doesn't mean that you can't do anything. We just have to find ways to adapt and overcome.
I love rubbing shoulders in these interviews with people that are just cut from a much finer fabric than I am. Matias, thanks for sharing your story. And boy, you're just a source of inspiration for everybody who's watching this.
Thank you very much, sir. Have a great day. Thank you.
Right back at you.